Boom, 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 boom. And I think we are set, team. So welcome, welcome, y'all. This is functional fitness training. So if it's the first time, hi to the new folks. Welcome back to the veterans. We do about 10 to 15 minutes of mobility that's different every week. And then we go into a strength set. So today's mobility set is going to be kind of arms, chest, because we're going to go and focus on a push and a pull circuit. We will still get an entire body workout, but we're focusing on that push-pull element today. So just something to elevate all that heavy bag carrying or any pushing you do in your life. Make sure you have room front, back, side to side. If you haven't already, you're gonna wanna grab, if you have one, a flat band, because we'll be doing some flies. No worries if you don't have it. I'll show you weighted options. And you're gonna wanna go a little bit probably lighter. By light, I mean something that you feel comfortable with doing flies, overhead presses, or tricep extensions with. And rows, so you still want some heavy, something heavy. So let's go ahead and get started. Seems like my little teeny, I used to have this little remote that's controlled all my music, but I think it's taking a vacation. So I'll be dealing with my sound on the phone. No worries, no texting here, just work. Let's start, team, let's start. Big arm circles. Oh, I want those thumbs pointing up. And then as you go around, kind of rotate them down. Thumbs up, rotate them down. That's just gonna get a little bit extra, kind of almost like a nerve flossing as you bring that arm up and over. Okay, let's go ahead and reverse that. So now thumbs go back and then bring it back up. Don't think about it too much. Just draw those circles. And as long as you're feeling a little something juicy in the arm, shoulders, you're doing good. About four more, three, two. And I'm going to ask you to grab a band slightly early today. So if you have the band, if you don't, just do the motion. We're going to grab it, palms down, and we're going to go squat to fly. Squat, and now pull that band apart. And so you're bringing the two corners of your shoulder blades together, right? So if you don't have that band, palms down, and really engage between the shoulder blades. Ooh, mobility already. Maybe even adding a little resistance. Let's do that four more times. Four, ooh, hold. Nice, team. And once you finish up that four for yourself, I'm gonna ask you to squat low, hold it, and I want you to take the thumbs up, 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 as high as they can go. And now back, 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 as far down back as your palms go. And just repeat that motion. Thumbs up, palms face each other. Palms back, facing the floor. About four of those. Oh goodness, this just became full body, warming up. Very good. And last one. Okay, go ahead and shake that out. We're coming to the top of our mat, warming up still the low body because we will be working. Nice big stride back here. Go ahead, alternate. Let's get that started first. There will be plenty of combination type movements today where you can integrate upper body with low body or just focus on one. So an example of that, if you want to add that upper body, palms like Frankenstein's, and when you go into that reverse lunge, draw the elbows back. Again, alternate. Oh, who said it wasn't going to be a party today with Frankenstein? Oh goodness. Yes, you can tell. If you're watching this live or even recorded, it is Halloween season for me. We got our pumpkins on in the background. Good, elbows wide. Keep alternating. I call these arms going from like an I to a W, yeah. Warming up there through the shoulders now. About four more. Breathe. And when you're done with that, let's stand on one foot. Okay, face one direction. Pick one leg and put it on the floor. The other leg is gonna hover. Now, single leg deadlift. Hinge it, hip back, and hip forward. Let's go. I think this is a better angle for you. So I'm gonna show, this is my standing hip. Push that hip back, torso facing the floor, and coming on up. This is our single leg deadlift variety. Now, along with the course of today, if you want to add upper body, follow along with me. Hands go out, and the hand that has that knee up is going to rotate open. So let's do that again. One single leg deadlift. Drop the chest. Careful. Knee up. The knee that's up. Rotate. A little bit of thoracic rotation. And waking up that proprioception. So if you feel like you are going for that topsy-turvy situation, that's okay. Try to do about four of those. The foot may be burning. You might have to put that foot down. That's part of the mobility. And I got one more here myself. And good golly goodness. So special. Okay, let's take that out. Same thing other side. So we start with that single leg deadlift, push that hip back, and we just warm up that foot. Going single leg deadlift, knee up. You can add in some just alternating arms to wake up the foot and hip. Good, push that hip back. Hip back. Knee over shin. And when you are all ready, you can add that rotation pivot. So go ahead, pivot towards that knee. And then single leg deadlift. Here we go, let's try that four times. Going down. Coming up. Rotate through the torso. That's one. Now you go your pace. Just fly and roll with whatever you got today. And last one, after that, I'm gonna ask you to grab your weight. Boom, 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 light weight or band, okay? So this is what's coming, so you know. Lightweight, we're gonna do behind the back passes. So as far as you can, we're gonna keep the hands up off the back of the torso and just pass that weight back and forth. If you got that band today, another option is to keep the shoulders back down and around and do pull aparts here. I just want something that activates the back, right? You can even just tap pulse. It's hard to do. We're gonna do that for 30 whopping seconds. On your marks, get set. Here we go. So slight hinge forward is okay. Now just pass that weight back and forth. We're taking care of the upper body today. Whoa, even 10 pounds can feel like a lot on these. Keep it wide. Small, little passes. Goodness, goodness. Oh, coming up on 15 seconds to go. We're cooking now. Going in 5, 3, 2, 1. Okay, team, go ahead, shake that out. Now, this is important because we'll see it later on in the workout, but we're gonna go from thumbs back, all the way around, hover the hands off the back of the torso, and go back up. So you're just going from a great big Y as far back as you can. And then you're gonna go back, 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 back. Let's keep drawing that. So thumbs up and back, draw it to a Y, keep the thumbs up and back, draw it back to that W. Let's do that four times. Four. There will be an opportunity to do this on the floor later. So palms touch, thumbs back, Y. We're refining this. Back, 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 back. Touch. Woo! And last one. So let it go. You didn't feel the nitty gritty of that. We will have more time to dive in that in the future. Coming down to all fours. Let's get a little deeper into the shoulders. Cat cow. Let's try to do something a little different. Animal shape today. So hands underneath the shoulders. You're going to that big arc and going into that hyper extension with the rib cage and the low body. Again, that's 4 and 3. 2 And last one, hands stay under the shoulders. I'm gonna ask you to take one hand, place it on the base of that neck, and you're gonna draw that elbow from horizontal to vertical. Here we go. So hand here, elbow to elbow, elbow to sky. Ooh, that's one. Elbow to elbow, elbow to sky. That's two. Ooh, a little snap, crackle, pop there. Good, press that palm of the hand into the floor. And last one, other side. We're almost through the mobility. The mobility is feeling like a lot of work right now. Let's go, elbow to elbow, other side. Elbow to ceiling. So good, y'all. Good, good, good. That's two. Three. And last one. Beautiful. Okay, step one foot back, one foot forward in a low lunge. We're here. And we're gonna add that rotational twist. This is the last mobility piece, I promise. If you want, grab a little weight to support you. You're going high and then threading under. Let's do that four times. Ready, set, low lunge, reach it up, thread the hand underneath. One, two, we're doing about four of them, about four. And last one, let's go ahead and switch to the other side. Get it groovy, lunge it, find it, grab that weight accordingly. Now let's go ahead and thread it under. So you're threading through the hole, add that pivot. Woo! Talk about 10 minutes of opening up that chest. So good. And go ahead, do your last one, and we're gonna dive into our circuits. Okay, team. So that whole warm-up warmed up our chest as well as our lats. We're working push and pull today, but it's gonna be full body. So, first exercise, couple options here. We got circuits of three and they're all a minute each. So option one is a press out. You're going here and you're going here. Option two is an overhead press. Only if you want, you can add a squat to press or squat to overhead press. You got a minute. You can make any fusion of a press. You could go knock it down in all presses or go squat to press, okay? So get your weights, adjust accordingly, and then I'll tell you the next exercise as it comes. Whew, I'm feeling good. How are we doing? Okay, let's start it up. Ready, set, and go. Okay, righty one, you're here, pressing out as far as you can go to control that core. You stay here if you want to focus on only upper body and core. If you want to go full body, one squat, one push. Good team. If your shoulders feel a-okay, you can go up and overhead with palms facing the body. Full extension, but soft elbows. Up to you if you want to add that squat to press. We're working on a minute. That was 40 seconds. So feel out. Is this too heavy? Does this feel challenging but doable? Because we got two more rounds to come later on. 5 more seconds. Keep that squat to press. We're gonna go slightly heavier in 3, 2, 1. Grab that medium to heavy weight. Deadlift to curl. So if you want, you could curl all day. Or one deadlift, one curl. On our marks, get set. We got a minute. Here we go. I'm gonna focus on the curl to start. So slightly hinge, palms face the body. Note a couple things. When I curl it, my elbow relatively stays where it is. If you're doing this, that's great, but this will give you a little bit more of that bicep pull, challenge. Good. Now, if you're feeling comfy and you want to add a little bit on, go to the shins, hinge it, stand tall, then curl. Try it out. Option to fuse it together. This is exercise number two, y'all. Two of three. 15 more seconds. Curl in. You could do every other if you went pretty heavy. 10 seconds now. Hold on to these heavy to medium weights for the next one. 3, 2, 1. Okay, team. Rock one. One big stride back. Row. So I'm leaning on that front leg in a lunge position. Let's set it up. One leg. Step it back. Big stride back. Hinge it. Here we go. Hold. So that row, again, that elbow just really is best friends with that rib cage right here. Pulling into side, if you pull any more, it gets the shoulder drop and it's a little impinging. Here's where we're gonna get all that lat engagement. Yes. Good. Long spine. So these are our three. Let's switch sides. Other side. Oh, take that transition time. Find that exact same pull on the other side. Push and pull, y'all. These are our push and pull sets. Yes, they got squats if you want them. Yes, you got hinges if you want them. And you almost got a lunge if you want it, yeah? This is the lunge position. So, in 5 seconds, we're gonna go back to the top of those three. That's that press out. 3, 2, 1, relax. So press out or press up. Select your weights. 1 minute, second set starts in 5 seconds to go. Okay, let's get a little juicy with it. Ready, set, here we go. Oh, full body push only if you want. Soft elbows, soft press out. Getting a little more familiar with that press. Pressing only if that speaks to you. This is a little more heat. A little more high intensity intervaling. Because it's a singular movement. Not a lot of whole times in life where we do this all day. A whole bunch of times in life we do this. Maybe. Picking something up, putting it over the fridge. That's functional. This is compound. Full body movement. Wow. Woo, 10 seconds. Ugh. Beautiful, single or double. Oh my goodness. Hitting the wall on this. 5 seconds now. Good team. 3, 2, 1. Okay, curls, okay? So again, options. Here, curl all day. You can add a balance. Or deadlift, stand tall, hinge. On your marks, get set. Round two curls, here we go. Hinge it, boom. So you are limited by how heavy you go with how much you can curl. Today we're focusing on that. Good. Try to separate out that hinge. As you come up, keep that forward lean. Watch out for that. This is gonna give you a little more core as you curl that heavy up. 10, 20 seconds to go. Ah, beautiful, y'all. 10 seconds now. You got it. Woo! 5 seconds here, come on. 3, 2, and 1. Plank row. Or, I'm sorry, runner's row. I wrote it down as plank row, but you're gonna have that coming up later. Big lunge back, lean it there. Ready, set, here we go. Throw it. All on one side. Beautiful, y'all. 10 more seconds. Stay long with that spine. 5 seconds now. 3, 2, other side. Boom. Set it up. We're on. Nice, y'all. push and pull, send it around. 10 seconds to go. 10 beautiful seconds turns into 5 strong seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay, this round I want to focus on the eccentric and, is it concentric? I'm losing my mind. I want you to go out and down mindfully, okay? That's all it is. So if you're doing overhead press or press outs, grab your weights. Here we go. So push out and slow control down. That's the eccentric phase. You get stronger as you resist the return. The eccentric phase. So if you're pressing out, out, and then don't just grab it in. Out, 3, 2, 1. Out, 3, 2, 1. Or push, 3, 2, 1. Push. Just making it a little different this third time around. The third round, we will always focus on a different tempo training, the eccentric phase. In fact, eccentric is so important, I forgot the opposite right now. It will come to me. Woo! 5 seconds coming up. Let's finish it out. In 3, 2, 1. Deadlift to curl. Eccentric phase here being going the down, 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 down. Curl, down, down, down. Add that to your deadlift if you want. Ready, set, here we go. Hinge it. Up, slow, slow, slow. Boom. First couple. Oh, feel reasonable. Then you're trying to make it go through mud as you just lower, lower, lower. Keep that full range as you lower, lower, lower. Lower, lower, lower instead of. Yeah, make it smooth, beautiful. Y'all keep at it. Mindful movement here. 5 seconds to go. Relax. Lunge row. You can go heavier because we're doing that tempo training. So there won't be as many reps. If you want, you can even cross over something you have that might be light. There's a lot of grip strength here. Ready, set. Here we go. Up. Slow, slow, slow. Elbow up. Down, down, down. Pull. Lower, lower, lower. Keep that pace. Good, y'all. This tempo training is training a different type of muscle fiber. So we move quick today, and we're also moving mindfully. Let's switch to the other side. Tempo training. Elbow to that cage. Down, down, down. Rib cage. Boom. Join me here. Come on. Keep that spine long. Good. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Shake it out. Grab some water. So that was our circuit. That's the pattern today. We will continue the push-pull. So, as you get water and take a little lap towel, I'm gonna show you what's up next. Light weights, options, single leg deadlift fly or hinge fly. Showing you on 2 feet first. It's a full hinge, hold, arms come apart. This is our pull. Only if you want to add a little instability, this means more core challenge and no back problems, you can go on that one leg, hold 30 seconds on one leg, 30 seconds on the other. Next up, we're going to the floor. Push-ups with the shoulder tap, knees or toes. Boom, this is our push. That's one option for the push. Second option for the push. Here, bridge up. Here, two. And then you do lift one leg. So what it is, double press, lift one leg, then press. It just adds a little bit of instability. The leg lift is optional. Now, third one, everyone's on the floor with me. So make sure you have room. Actually, no, I take it back. I wrote in an option. Option one, here. Go into the swimmers, extending from what we did to start. Our hands go back in a Y. They hover as your torso is lifted off the floor. That's exercise number three. If you don't want to be on the floor or prefer to rock out this strength option, you can do the behind the back passes instead. Three exercises. Pull push, lat extension, okay? So let's start out with that pull, the fly. Grab something light, it's 1 minute long. We all know the struggle bus on that. Let's get started in 3, 2, 1. Okay, team, if you're starting with me, I'm gonna start on 2 feet. Hinge it, knees above shins, palms face the body. Now, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Only go as high as you can feel them engage and only to shoulder height. This is where I want you to stop. This is too far. Here, I call it like a rainbow or a bow and arrow arm because you don't really go further than that, right? You make a soft curve. Only if you want, add that instability. Try it with me if you want, friends. Maybe do 2 reps per side and try the other side. Because this is the hello round. We try it first. Second round, we get comfy with it. Third round, we do our tempo training. 5 seconds now. We're coming to the floor in 3, 2, 1. Recap on the pushes. Knees or toes. One tap, one push. Knees or toes, or on your back. Double press, one leg out, double press. Getting started in 3, 2, 1. If you're starting with me, I want your hands at an almost 45 degree angle to allow your chest to drop here. Imagine you're pushing a refrigerator on the floor. Here we go. Down, up, tap. One push, one tap. Now, crucial. You don't gotta come all the way to the floor, team. I prefer the range where you can control without arching your shoulders or your neck. Go as far down as you can, keeping everything elongated, and push. That chest is doing the work. It's opening up through the chest and then pushing. Good, shoulder tap. Same thing if you're on your back. Wide arms, narrow. Wide and narrow, 10 seconds to go. I envision it to be wide and narrow, but the hands really don't move if you're doing a push-up. 3, 2, 1. Okay, team, if you're on the floor, mark it with me. Other friends are passing that weight behind the back. Floor friends, let's get it on in 5 seconds. I want you to start with an extension, okay? Ready, set, here we go. Head long, extend and hover the feet. Extend and hover the thumbs up. Now look at the floor and circle the arms. Go from a Y. Touch the hands behind the back. Keep the hands as far off in the back as you can and now go back to the Y. Y to almost an O. For those of you who are exploring this new shape, look at my hands. They go up from a Y. They come and they circle over, thumbs drop. And then I almost make an O on my back as I touch the hands. So try that shape, but keep the chest extended. It feels oh so, I hate to say it, unreasonable. It looks simple, but really we are challenging that extension to the spine, and that's kind of like a pull. 5 seconds, go from that Y to that O, and relax. Okay, so we explored those shapes, we're going back to the top. Okay. Let's get nice and groovy with it. It starts with a fly. 2 feet if you want, or start on that single. Ready, set, here we go. Hinge it, fly it. Let's go for that soft bow and arrow arc with the arms. Whoa, goodness. Breathe in, keep that head long, spine long. Nice team. 10 seconds if you're doing that balance. We'll switch to the other side. We got it. 4, 3. And we're halfway. Switch sides if you want. Keep that hip even. It's a challenge. I know. Not easy, but functional. We often do our push and pulls with a lower body element in life. When you're reaching to get something, yeah? 5 seconds here. 3, 2, 1. Okay, the push, either on your back or push up, okay? I'm gonna demo on my back. On your mark, some sort of push. Ready, set, here we go. I'm joining the friends who are on their backs. Do a single push, extend, press again. Again, double feet on the floor, single foot on the floor. Just keeping it interesting as an option. By all means, we can go chest press here if you're going heavy or you prefer to focus on that strength. Nice team, relax the face as you do these pushes. Isolating here. Three seconds, two, and one. Coming to standing if you're doing that behind the back passes. Otherwise, we're doing that extension here. Remember, you make a Y shape, thumbs back. And you circle around to that O with the hands off the back. Ready, set, here we go. Let's start with that extension. Spine long, feet off the floor. Dive in to the Y. Circle, circle, keep it lifted, lifted, lifted. Good. Pulling that belly button away from the floor will give you more core activation here, team. Pull that belly button away or envision as it is lifting off the floor. Breathe. Keep going in 3, 2, and 1. Okay, having so much fun with these, we're gonna add that tempo option, okay? So that's that slow lower back to home base. We'll start with the fly on this. Third round, best round. Let's dive in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Pull, slow, slow down. Up, slow, lower down. Try to breathe through this. No specific breathing pattern, but no chest holding either. Good. Single is totally appropriate if you're feeling a little petered. Yeah, maybe you went heavy and you went at your best effort and single feels challenging but doable. Try to hold on one at a time. Good, y'all. We've been doing push and pull this entire workout. I expect it to get sticky. Just a little, in it right now. 5 seconds and 3 seconds. Relax, okay. The push, slow lowers. Up, slow down the weight. Up, slow down the weight. Let's start that in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Push, tap, slow, slow, slow. Push, tap, slow, slow, slow. Push, tap. Friends on the chest presses, you're at that same tempo. Up, boom, boom, boom. Up, boom, boom, boom. Good, y'all. 20 seconds. Do not be afraid to take that instability element out. Plenty of work here. Plenty of work in just the push. Plenty of work in the push. 10 seconds. 5 seconds here. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Behind the back passes. This one is just slow. There's not really any tempo training to it. It's just moving through mud. Let's move through mud together. Going from the Ys to the circles or behind the back passes. You're on, friends. You're on. Breathe. To feel that lower, I want you to just imagine money behind you that you're trying to grab up top. Ooh, just getting that little inch of a piece higher, like you're reaching for something right millisecond behind you, a milli-inch behind you. 10 more seconds as you draw those shoulders back, 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 and relax. Okay, team, we're gonna chill it out. Good for you. Good for us. Yes. Okay. Stay on the floor if you got up. Good job. Very functional. We're going to start with a little bit of stretching through the shoulders. Come to a seated or kneeling position. Hands behind the back. Let's take the shoulders and just roll them up, back, and around. We did a big push-pull series. We're going to open up that chest. So I tuck the chin and nice deep breaths here. 4 times. Ready, set. Here we go. Taking the hands up and over. One hand behind towards the back. Shoulders dropping back down and around. 4 breaths here. Expand the rib cage, but keep it grounded. So. With the arc, you'll get more stretch and grounding that rib cage. 4 breaths. Other side, team. Good team. We're on that second side, just breathing 4 deep breaths into that shoulder girdle. So this is just such good workout for all our in general, because life is a lot of low body, but not too much of that thoracic instability. So yay, we got that in today. And if you're finding someone who feels stiff in the upper body, it's a great workout to come back to. You can either find it on my website, maybe you're doing it now from there. Thumbs up. Let's do a nice child's pose stretch. Drop that head, letting that spine be long. If you are someone who's not on the floor, but outside, find something to prop you up and find that similar child's pose stretch. We're just stretching the lat here from all those rows. Walk the fingertips from one side, from the center to one side. Getting a little bit of that extra side stretch. Good, 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 friends. And other side. Walk it, walk it, walk it, walk it, walk it, walk it. Ooh, and breathe. Nice, team. Coming with your hands underneath the floor, underneath the shoulders. You're just gonna take one leg. You're gonna thread it through, if it feels good to you, into a pigeon and letting it go. Or if you want, sitting on that 90-90 or on a chair. Figure 4. Nice piriformis stretch. Option today to add a slight pivot as feels good to you. So that would just mean taking your fingertips and slightly walking them to one side. Enjoying all that goodness there. stretch it out to the other side. So retrograding it, plank, other knee thread through, relaxing into that pigeon or coming to that 90-90. 90-90 is that knee. So you can get that 90 degrees back in front and relax into it. Now walk the fingertips a little bit to the side if you want that thoracic twist. Beautiful, y'all. Coming to a quick downward dog or second set of lat stretch standing. Hands under shoulders, tuck the toes, up. Coming to standing, we're gonna take the hands up and over behind the chest. We're gonna do a second set of these, but a different focus. Shoulders back down and around, ear to shoulder. Flipping on down, let that neck elongate and stretch. Four breaths. Look on up. And other side, ear to shoulder, drop the chin, cross in the hands. Looking on up. Beautiful, y'all. Take your legs nice and wide here. We're coming to that low squat. Knees in line with toes. Hook the elbows in to upper thighs, drop the hips, holding there. If you want, take one hand, add that slight pivot, dropping that shoulder. Other side. Good job, team. We're going to do three big reaches. Here we go. We're going to focus on the thumbs going up and around today. Going up, 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 up. Take all that shoulder through the full range of motion and just slowly let it go. Yeah, we've done a lot of those already. Two more like that. Up, 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 up. Take it all in and slowly bring the arms back down. One more like that. Up. Big reach, big lift. Take it all in and let it all go. Give yourselves a hand. Really great job today on that push-pull series. If you guys have been dropping in with me with the other recordings, I know since I was gone a little bit, we did our squat. No, I was going to do squat hinge, but I'm thinking we're doing that next week. But so good to be here.